Hello children, welcome to the biology class. So previous class we have discussed about the friends, mosses, types of plants and the lifespan of plants. Now today's class we are going to discuss about the flowering plants. So flowering plants are higher plants that produce flowers and reproduce through seeds. So flowering plants are again classified into two types, that is angiosperms and gymnosperms. Angiosperms, what are angiosperms and what are gymnosperms? Angiosperm, that means a plant case which contains seed. The flowers of these plants are complex in structure and seeds remain. And seeds will remain. But gymnosperms, gymnosperms are naked seed. So plants where the naked seed can be seen. These are naked seeded plants with very simple flowers that form cones. That forms cones. For example, of a pine tree and cycads. That means gymnosperms own seed can be seen. But in angiosperms, it is a complex structure and after that the seed will remain. So, flowering and non-flowering plants. So, angiosperms are flowering plants where the flower is seen and seed will remain. But in gymnosperms, where seed will be the big, that means non-flowering plant. Next, gymnosperm, microscopic female gametophyte inside the ovulate cone. This is a pine tree. And microscopic male gametophyte inside a pollen cone, that is sporophyta. So, in angiosperms, the male gametophyte inside these parts of a flower. That means which it will remain, but it will present inside the flower in angiosperms. So, angiosperms are what? Flowering plants. And gymnosperms are non-flowering plants because the seeds will be seen outside. For example, strawberry also. And microscopic female gametophyte inside the parts of the flower. Both male and female parts can be seen in the flower that is present inside. But in gymnosperms, female gametophyte and male gametophyte can be seen outside the fruit. So gymnosperms, simple definition is non-flowering plant. Angiosperms, flowering plant. And next, coming to monocot and dicot. So here monocotyledons. So what is this monocot and dicotyledons? Depending upon the number of seeds, the number of seed leaves, those are called cotyledons. So enclosed within the fruits, depending on the number of seed leaves which are cotyledons they contain, they may be divided into two categories, that is monocot and dicot. So mono means single, cot seed, so which have one seed leaf, which have one seed leaf, they are angiosperms. Monocotyledons are angiosperms in which a seed has only one cotyledon. What is the meaning of cotyledon? Seed leaf. Maize, for example, maize, rice, coconut, palm and sugarcane are the example of monocot. And dicotyledons. Dicotyledons are angiosperms in which the seed has two cotyledons. For example, pea, bean, mustard, sunflower and some seed. Cereals, banyan tree are example of dicots. Badam, those are, that is almond. So, which are having two seeds. See in the picture, you can see. See monocot, maize. For example, maize and rice, which is having one seed leaf. And dicot, which is having two seed leaf. So, for example, groundnut. So, you can open that, you can break it. So, monocots and dicots will also show the structural difference in their vascular bundles, leaves and flowers. So, next comes to the classification of animals. So before that, children, habitat of plants are also very important, which includes xerophytes, mesophytes and hydrophytes. Xerophytes, that means plants which grow in dry condition, that is drought areas where the water is limited. So those plants are called xerophytes. For example, cactus. Mesophytes are the plants that grow in the condition where average supply of water will be there. For example, a rose, tomato are example of mesophytes. And next, hydrophytes. Hydro means what? Water. So plants which grow in water or under the surface of water are hydrophytes. Best example is lotus, water hyacinth are example of hydrophytes. Next, classification of animals. So animals can be classified based on the following features due to the presence and absence of backbone. So due to the animals are classified into two types, that is due to the presence of and absence of backbone. So animals that have a vertebral column are called vertebrates, or animals which have backbone are vertebrates, and animals which do not have or absent of vertebral column or backbone are called invertebrates. Vertebrates are again classified into reptiles, fishes, amphibians, birds, mammals. So vertebrates are classified into reptiles, fish, amphibians, birds, mammals. Invertebrates are again, invertebrate means absent, vertebrate presence, absence of backbone. Vertebrae means what? Backbone. So invertebrates are classified into protozoa, flatworms, annelids, echinodermata, coelenterata, arthropoda and molluscans. So again, arthropoda are classified into arachnids, crustaceans, insects and myriapods. So reptiles which have dry scaly skin and lay eggs on dry land are cold-blooded animals. Those are, for example, reptiles like lizard, chameleon, snake, crocodile are the examples of reptiles. And fishes, you know that they have scaly skin, scales will be there on their bodies, and they have gills, a specialized structure for the breathing, and they are cold-blooded animals. For example, shark and amphibians, almost they have moist, slippery and slimy skin. They lay eggs in water and they are cold-blooded animals. For example, frog. And next, birds. So their body structure is they have feathers and wings to fly, and they have toes, so they have beaks, and birds will lay eggs and they are warm-blooded animals. For example, birds, you know, parrot, crow, swan. Mammals. Mammals, they have fur or hair on their skin, and they give direct birth to their young ones, and they feed young ones on milk. So they are categorized as mammals. Mammals which gives milk to their young ones are mammals, and they are warm-blooded animals. For example, cow, humans, dog are example of mammals. Next, invertebrates. First classification, first one is protozoa. So what is a protozoa? Single cell organisms, and they are minute and they can be seen under microscope. And flatworms, they are simple soft bodies, for example tapeworm and flukes, so which are present in the intestine of animals. Next, annelids. So annelid is what? Their body is slippery, very slimy, they are very soft, and they have segmentation of body can be seen. So for example, earthworm and leech. Next, echinodermata. So they have spiny sea creatures. They have spines over their body. For example, starfish and sea urchin. Next, coelenterata, which is having coelom. It's a body structure. They are soft bodies. They are having soft body and stinging cell. For example, jellyfish and sea anemones. And next is arthropoda. Arthropoda, from here the classification of higher animals will start. The hard external skin skeleton, and they will have jointed limbs. From arthropods we can see the development of animals. They have legs to creep, to move. Next, molluscans. Molluscans are soft body, and most of them they will have shells. So molluscans, shell, for example snail. So arthropods again, archinids, that is archinids, 8 legs and 2 body parts, no antennae. For example, spider and scorpion. Next, crustaceans. Mostly crustaceans are sea creatures. They have many legs and 2 sets of antennae on their head. For example, crab and lobster. Next, insects. You know, insects will have wings, 6 legs and 3 body parts and 1 pair of antennae on their head. For example, bee and ladybird, and honeybee also. Next, myriapods. They will have many legs. They have many legs and body is segmented. For example, centipede and millipede. This is the classification of animals. In detail about each one, we'll discuss tomorrow, their characteristic feature. Okay, children, have a good day.